Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's still early in the season, but a lot can be learned from early matchups in conference play. Time to take you out to the Pac-12. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
It opened in 1923. It's hosted Olympic Games, popes, and presidents, and so much more. We're in Los Angeles, and kickoff is straight ahead. And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He'll take it from the two. At the 30. And down he goes at the 37.
You gotta love opening the game with a solid kick return like this.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Fires it out. A yard on the play action that time.
Gain of one on the play. That makes it second and eight.
He throws right. Tackled around the 40-yard line.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
Tackle made at the 33. First down grab by the receiver, brought down around the 25-yard line. That play is good for 8 yards and a first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
Got it, and he goes down quickly. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53.
He gets rid of this one. Roach's stats are doing all the talking right now. He's one of the nation's elite players. And Herbie, we watched him on film. His motor is always running, high energy, a lot of talking. More importantly, he really demonstrates some leadership out there, too.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
So it's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. USC could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. King gets set to kick this one away. It's fielded at the two. He's taken down at the 31. Boise State's coaching staff, they know they've got a star wide receiver. They know it's going to be a hostile environment. With that, we went to practice this week, Kirk. They had a crowd noise pumped up pretty good getting them ready for this game.
Yeah, they've done everything that they can do to get this offense ready for a tough environment. They had the crowd noise all week long, making it tough to communicate for the quarterback and his receivers. Now it's here. Now it's the game. And we'll see if all that preparation pays off. One thing we know for sure, they want to get the football into the hands of this receiver early and often if they want to win this game.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. The Trojans lose one of their key players with that injury earlier. Still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that he'll play any more football this afternoon.
He decides to run with it. It's recovered, and he's taken down at the 43-yard line. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And great awareness by the defense to jump on.
Call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession. USC has a three-point lead. Out of bounds, right around the 40.
That makes it second and eight.
Tailback, but he can't bring it in.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33.
Let's go, let's go. Hey, we got Mike.
Throws incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
That makes it fourth and eight.
Fry is the punter.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
Well, I'm sure the offense will be looking to avoid the turnover that ended their last drive.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
He's taken down right around the 4-yard line. Dean gains about a yard on the play. Second down. This is a dangerous situation backed up against their goal line. The fullback rumbles ahead for about a yard. Jumbo set. Nice run there as they work the outside. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series. Combination of a couple things, but I think the defenses are playing well, but I think the offenses at this point are making it a little bit easier for them. So let's see if these offenses can get it going a little bit to try to challenge these defenses.
We're about set to start things up again. USC holds a field goal lead. And that one's incomplete.
Number 81 was the intended receiver on the play.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Throws this one away.
You're not ready. Let's go. Hey, we got Mike. 53.
And he's leveled at the 47-yard line.
That is a loss of 5 on the play. Fourth down.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. The Trojans are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you've talked to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down like that.
He's tackled right around the 38-yard line.
Second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Zips it to the back. They'll bring him down at the 41. Butler picks up about 3 with that catch.
Nice throw and catch there to get past the sticks.
That makes it first and 10.
There are 3 quarters remaining. USC's got a 3-point lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. He scrambled. And they make the stop right around the 48-yard line.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. To catch it. He's got nowhere to go. Third and 5 coming up. Ball on the 43. Now he's scrambling. And he is drilled at the 30-yard line.
That's good for gain of 13 yards. First down.
Inside the 10, and he's tackled at the 7. He kept it himself and picked a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he hits the PAT. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
We take you to Winston-Salem. And for Wake Forest, once again, this game just goes to show you, never take anything for granted in college football. The Broncos have the edge, 3-0.
7-3 in this one. Rucker is lined up to kick this one off.
Number 81, deep to return.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Looking for his man, incomplete.
You know, some of the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
Loss of 12 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Out of bounds around the 31-yard line. Kendrick is back to receive. And he's taken down the 39-yard line.
Kendrick's got the first of what should be many tackles to come. He's a heck of a player, really explosive and quick, a sure tackler, as you can see on that one.
There hasn't been too much daylight between the two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Boise State holds a four-point lead.
Tackled after decent pickup.
That brings up second and five.
We've got a second and five. Ball on the 44. He's going to try and scramble. And down he goes at about the 45. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what, in today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
He's scrambling. That's a great tackle at the 45-yard line.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
From the 45-yard line, it's second down. They'll get him for a loss.
Job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Hartman looking to get some distance on this one and give his team the field position advantage. And he just got drilled. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Incomplete. Almost picked off. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it. Let's go,
let's go. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. There's a strike complete. He's down.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do.
Him hard at the 38.
Quarterbacks just love this scenario. He had his man one-on-one on a corner route versus man coverage, and you just saw it. It results in an easy first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38.
complete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
Flips it middle to the running back. Tackle right around the 46-yard line. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Brad, I don't know about you, but it looked to me that they just miscommunicated. It looked like the wide receiver was going in one direction and the quarterback was throwing it another direction. They definitely need to get on the same page.
Fry is waiting for the snap. One of the nation's top talents really struggling in this one today. Dawson's big playability was supposed to be on display, and yet he's trying to find any kind of rhythm. And we've seen the team rally around him, though, and they got the lead here.
Yeah, and Brad, this defense has done just a great job of being able to take him out of this game today. They've been able to really just limit his touches. And yet, for some reason, they still find themselves trailing in this game. So I think it's a good example of how one player can alter a defensive game plan and really puts this defense in a position where they're going to have to make some adjustments here and try to put more pressure on this team and get the ball back to their own offense.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Boise State is up four. He's going to take off. He's at midfield, brought down around the 44-yard line. First down. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. He gets hit out of bounds around the 21-yard line. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there, and one of his guys can come down with it. Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 21. He flings it left. Looking for six, and he got it. Touchdown. And he converts the extra point. A six-play, 71-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
It is my job to come in and rain on a parade.
I know
everything's gone right. I know they have all the momentum. I know that every little detail of the game plan has gone exactly as scripted.
But
overconfidence, too happy, too satisfied. How big a problem is that in the second half?
But you always have the excitement coming into the first half of a ball game, and you think it's going to be close when teams like this are evenly matched. But that doesn't mean you can lose your edge. That doesn't mean you can get complacent. A lot of times we see passion and energy in the first half, and it starts to wither away. They got to make sure that they keep the energy up, continue to make plays. Don't think that you're there, because we've seen momentum switch like that. As soon as somebody flips a switch, it's hard to get it going back in the other direction. So you got to take advantage of these opportunities.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Fielded at the four. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Scrambling around. And he tackles him hard at the 32-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Gives it right side, and he's taken down at about the 31. Play action. He'll scramble. Decides to slide.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
From their own 41-yard line, it's first down. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
First down.
Taken down at the 45.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 45. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And they push him out right around the 36-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
Makes the tackle at the 31-yard line. That brings him second and five.
From the 31-yard line, second down. He's hit and taken down. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. He scrambled. The five. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Now he's scrambling. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the three. Across the 30. Tackle made at the 40. Boise State's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
He's tackled at the 42. A nice-looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Right, go down. Let's go.
him down around the 25-yard line.
Middle linebacker came on a blitz. Be very disruptive. Sometimes a quarterback will get happy feet when they see that coming. Not this guy. He's very composed and can deliver under a pass rush.
Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. And they make the stop at about the 21.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and 5.
He makes it to the 18-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That makes it third and 3.
He's going to come up short. Good tackle. Gatewood gets about a yard on the play. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. He gets it up, and he got it. King looks ready to kick this one off. Kendrick fields at the goal line. The Broncos had that hot hand on offense, and they just keep on going here in quarter number 3.
The greatest thing you could say about these guys today is consistency. They are moving the football and putting points up on the board. They're going to be tough to beat.
This offense just torched the defense through the air with a great passing attack on their last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
From their own 44-yard line. First down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That'll make it second and 4.
And this is still anyone's ball game as we head into the final quarter of play. 21-6, Boise State. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 44.
Called a gain of 6 yards. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a deep one. That makes it 2nd and 6.
To see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34. Slings it to his tight end, but he drops it. See if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. And he he's tackled at the 22.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. Only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
The offense goes back out onto the field after picking up a field goal on their last drive. Throws it in a hurry. And down he goes to 37-yard line. Throws it out, knock loose.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. Catches it, and that's all. From the 48-yard line, second down. He gets rid of this one. They'll line up with five wide receivers. That's a great tackle at the 36. Just under three to go in regulation. Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete. We're at play number nine of this current drive. Caught with room to work. And he's level at the 27. It out to about the 24-yard line. And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. And he hits him hard at the 2-yard line. Breaks a tackle and he'll score. Touchdown. And
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Just under 2 minutes in the game. The ball pops free. Picks up the loose ball. They don't get it. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked ninth. After the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the bolsters move them down?
So you think any team can just roll their headgears out in the middle of the field and everybody's going to fall over and bow down to them? No. A major upset is now final. The Broncos cruise by 19.
Wow, what an upset. I'm not sure anybody would have predicted that one. They'll bring him down at the 39. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He gets to about the 31-yard line. Dean gains 8 yards on that play. USC just took their first timeout. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Gets out to around the 22.
He gets another set of downs, and more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Outside after a nice pickup. Butler picks up about 7 yards on the run. USC's out of timeouts. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Hands off left, and he's brought down quickly. A little over a minute in the game. Around the 3 yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. Dawson's day comes to an end, not how he had planned it to go, but hey, team rallied around him beautifully.
Brad, I think you and I and everybody else expected a big day for him individually, and he didn't deliver. But most importantly, the team, Chad, was able to come up and kind of step in for his absence and win this football game.
Well, that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.